up, everybody? Welcome to the fifth episode of My Road to World Orienteering Championships. And today is the first run, the start of the Yo Cup in Tampere, which is technically Night Cup. We are going to have 5 races, night, mass start. We'll see who's the best. Like last year, I was such a noob. I remember I was just running without a plan and I was so confused what's happening. But this year, let's do this. Like, look at me, I'm ready. I'm ready to go. So let's go to the forest and let's do the first race. Alright, so I'm the tall guy in the middle, and to the left of me is Friedrich from Poland and Andrew from Australia. Gotta say that this international trio did some trash talking before the start, but it's alright, it's all friendly competition, let's do this.
Labāk pat nedomā, vai rīkoties vērts, vari pīkstēt kā bērns, bet es labāk cīnos kā svērts un rēks.
Alright, so the beginning was really good, and I must say I was quite pushing at this point because I was trying to follow Sorsa at all costs because he's just an amazing runner, and running up this hill I was getting so tired because he had such a high pace and Mikko Nuttila caught me, and by the sixth control I was so tired that I actually led ourselves into a mistake, which I realized a little faster than he did. But still, that was a mistake, and Sorsa is already in the mist, as they say. I was like, let's just look at the compass and look how straight we went to the 7th control. Just beautiful. And as I was following Mikko right here, I thought that Sorsa is already so far ahead of us. But as you can see, like, even a mistake of 1 minute isn't actually as significant as I thought it is during the run. And here Mikko made a mistake where I overtook him a little bit. As you can see, Groen and Fredrik Prim also made a mistake to the 6th, so I don't know, maybe it was a difficult control. Yeah, after Butterfly, I can't say that this forest was very runnable, because even in the white forest, the rocks on the ground were so unpredictable, and I fell into deep holes like 5 times, so luckily I didn't break any legs. Unfortunately, as you can see, Andrew quit because he hurt his hand quite badly. But yeah, as I was climbing up the last hill, I was so tired and I made a little small mistake due to which Riku and Korpif passed me, but I'm still glad I beat Frederick, because we all know that running faster than your friend always feels good. Sorry, man. Alright, so today is a beautiful day to do some hill repetitions. We're 2 days out from the second Yo Cup, and last one went alright. And I hope I will not overtrain for this one, because I have, like yesterday I did some weight training, today I'm doing hill repetitions, tomorrow I'm going on a medium long run with Friedrich Prima, and yeah, we'll see how I feel on Thursday, but let's do this. So I did small hill and a big hill with some rests between, and for the first rep I tried to get the segment crown, which I got. I'm super happy about it. One day before Yo Cup number 2, I'm going in a long run, mid-range long run, with Friedrich Prima. Thank you, man, for suggesting this, because it's always fun to run together. Alright, for the second Yo Cup, the competition is insane. There was like Alexis Sorsa, Anton Kukka, Elias Kukka, Timo Sealed, and guys like that. Like, that is going to be crazy. And I don't feel recovered yet from yesterday and the day before. Let's try to find the right controls. Let's do this.
Frederick, how do you feel?
I feel good, yeah.
Feeling good, ready?
Yeah,
ready,
yeah.
To destroy?
Well, not to destroy, but better than last week. So. It's good to be in your TV series now, so I feel... It's for the future, you say?
For the future, yes.
For the future. That's amazing.
Look at those.
No, it's not sponsored.
You shouldn't put it.
Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2-seat Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk. Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2-seat Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk.
So I actually made a mistake to the third one, where I followed Alexis Sorsa to the other forking, and I don't know why GPS doesn't show that. Yeah, the start was rough, and I was surprised to see that Sorsa was making so many mistakes in the GPS. As you can see, I didn't find the 6th, I found the 7th before the 6th, and Sorsa made the same mistake. I didn't see him in the forest. Maybe I did see his light, but I wasn't trying to catch that light because I thought it's not any of the leads. And yeah, I was just unmotivated to push at this point. But yeah, we always need to learn that even the elites make mistakes, so I should have pushed and tried to catch that light. Nonetheless, the remaining of the race went alright. Really enjoyed the forest, it was just spectacular.
Alright, I mean, that was difficult. I must say that when I didn't find the sixth control, I was a little mad. I had to run the rest of the course alone, which wasn't very helpful in terms of the result.
Alright, so this is the day after you woke up. Now I need to get some recovery. So I'll do an hour on the bike in the gym. And my goal is to actually wear something that drips. I'll wear something that absorbs all of my fluids, all of my sweat, and we'll see if I can get anything out of it after the workout. So I got an apartment across from the park, put quinoa in my fridge, still I'm not feeling right. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to go. And I waited 20 minutes for that guy to leave. Try hard enough. I mean, that was a good training, but fuck. Feel like I'm gonna puke, cause my taxes are due. Do my password begin with a one or a... And today I had the idea to do the Inger Brixton day, which is basically a double workout day. You have longer intervals in the morning and shorter ones in the evening, and I'll be doing a 5x5 minute threshold pace run on the treadmill because I don't want to go outside. And in the evening I'll be doing a 400 meter repeat workout, so yeah, we'll see how it goes. And we cried and we laughed and had a really, really, really good time. Take my hand, let's have a blast and remember this moment for the rest of our lives. Damn. Finished it. Feeling great. I was listening to Macklemore when I was running. Oh my god, so easy. Just hit home. The songs of Macklemore, so good. Am I right? Dance! Feels like a night for a party. My niche, so naughty. So I was actually in the front by the fourth control, and I was running with Groen the whole time, and my GPS didn't work, so you can look at Groen's GPS. And our group is going to the right upper diagonal. Anyways, you can look down below how Sealed and Hostel are making mistake, and as you can see, best in the world making mistake. That's what Orienteering is all about. So yeah, pretty entertaining, I guess. Yeah, yeah. And we danced, oh, and we cried, oh, and we laughed, oh, and had a really, really, really good time. Oh, take my hand, oh, let's have a blast, oh, and remember this moment for the rest of our lives. I am not going to stand on the wall. I will dance, I will dance.
Was not very easy, this terrain again.
Yeah.
Well, in the beginning here I didn't focus very well. But suddenly okay. I found myself from number four and I wasn't quite sure that if I had actually punched that one or did I miss it totally.
And what did you go back? Like
it was actually rather demanding from that direction.
That was such a good run. I'm so happy. We made a couple of mistakes as you saw, but I mean, I'm glad. I'm really glad that today went really good. So, nice. Look at my dinner. Cooking up a whole broccoli. Mom? There is no mom here. I have to sew my leggings by myself. I'm actually doing this the first time, so wish me luck. This already a classic. You embarrassed already. The flow is breaking the levee. The motor is shaking the Chevy. Reality fucking you over. The op ain't taking a vacay. You gotta be all about your business and start doing the hey. Checks is balancing. My label ain't gambling. You gotta. I ran like 400 meters of elevation right now. I'm feeling great. I'm listening to some great podcast. It's a beautiful day. I'm so happy. You gotta fail your way to the top. It's a lesson whenever you fly, but it's a blessing whenever you lost. You gotta spend money to floss, or you gotta spend money to win. Or I want some big money to lend, and I'ma go flip something again. When I walk like, talk like, show money if my spirit ain't feeling it.
Alright, so this is one day before 4th Yoke Cup, and today is Rusko Tuska, which is a mass starting, and I'm going there right now. It is going to be 12 kilometers in length, so I'm not sure how fresh I'll feel tomorrow, but I mean, sounds fun. Some pizza, some sauna afterwards. Who would miss it, right? So the idea of Ruska Tuska is running a really long distance together with your bros with a really bad map, and that was just a great time. My GPS got frozen. Nonetheless, it was a great run, and we ran 19 kilometers, which is way too much as I was expecting before. But honestly, it was all worth it because afterwards we had great sauna and kebabs and pizza. Oh my god, such a great night.
So unity is a five-letter word.
Hopefully it's easier than yesterday's race.
Exactly.
Okay, 1, 2, 3 plus me. Monkeys in the barrel. Don't send no more teeth. Grab my brother pearls. I'm like 4 or 5 feet from the road in there. Tribe looks so OP, son, you wouldn't dare. Yeah, like the Rat Pack Blight when we does that. And it's tap, tap, swipe, cause the buzz back. And I'm flying, I'm a wipe, that's a must have. Baby say that I'm a Rony type. You know we gon' start a holly smoke. Every single time, and if somebody try my brother, I think I might start a riot. I'm a messiah, give me peace of mind, so I don't switch to violence. At the highest thing, I might be biased. You ain't gotta buy it. I decided if we building some, we do it like the Mayans and the Giants playing ice spy. And now they wanna try it. Ain't no honor, really stay abiding. Tribe is multiplying, they been lying, and we high fiving. Gang is on the rise. What's up?
Okay, we're done. So Andrew, was it easy? Was it easy?
I wouldn't say it was easy, but I at least had good company for the whole race.
Yeah, we were running together as a group, and somehow it felt like this is a normal training, not a competition.
Yeah,
it's weird.
It was chill.
Yeah, it was chill.
But fun. Yeah.
Yeah, nice. Well, hey, today is the last Yoke Cup, and this month went by so quickly. So this is the last race. And the competition is as crazy as ever. Like, every good runner in Tampere is going to be there. So if I get like top 10, I'll be happy. Yeah. So unfortunately my forking was very bad and I was already at the end of the pack at the first control. So going on, I tried to hold on, but the forest was so difficult to run in. There were many rocks. And unfortunately, I twisted my ankle like 3 times. I think such competitions are very important that you run with your group, because right here I was next to the control. GPS doesn't show it, but I made like a minute mistake standing next to the control. And right here I wasn't just confident at all. And if I would have ran with a group, then I would be confident. You know, that's how it goes, because running alone, it's just slower. And that is what went today. And I actually got a stick in my foot. Luckily nothing too serious, but it hurt like hell, and I made small mistakes to the 14th, to the 15th, to the 16th. But you see, that's how it goes, and sometimes these competitions are going well and sometimes they aren't. And even though I wasn't 10th in this race, in the sum total I was 11th out of so many competitors, and this was such a great competition. As always, Yoke Cup is like the highlight of the off season. So I'm happy, I'm real happy. And that is it for this year's Yoke Cup. And I must say, I have gotten my confidence up. I am ready to prepare for next season, running with the elites, because this was like a trial, you know? Because I could run with them. And I mean, this wasn't like competition pace. Often at times, it didn't feel that fast for me. So I could follow them. And yeah, I'm just very happy that I did well this year, because this motivation is going to be needed for the dark winter months of training. And that's it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
And we danced, and we cried, and we laughed, and had a really, really, really good time. Take my hand, let's have a blast, and remember this moment for the rest of our lives.